The storm may have passed, but the massive clean-up is just beginning on the mid-north coast. Coffs Harbour was battered by giant hail, strong winds and heavy rain, with a damage bill expected to run into the hundreds of millions.
A day after a supercell storm they'll never forget. Locals banded together and went to work, clearing the damage and debris.
But everybody suffered around here. This guy, skylight, water through the house, down the road, carport on a car. What do you do?
Huge hailstones rained down on Tormina and Sortel just south of Coffs Harbour yesterday afternoon.
I really don't want to be here right now.
Causing roofs to collapse. Broken windows.
Oh,
and flash flooding.
We've got four dogs in the backyard and it was coming down like that and I thought they'd be all dead because they were just running around in circles. I couldn't get out there to get them because it was that strong.
Today, the hail was still thick on the ground, some making the most of the situation. The SES, with the help of fire and rescue and police, working through almost 1,000 calls for assistance, the highest in Coffs history. The skylights in this nursing home smashed in, the hail also damaging hundreds of cars. The race is now on to batten down the hatches, with more wild weather on the way.
It's likely to be heavy rain and also perhaps damaging wind gusts, but hail is much less likely of a threat today.
Kate Creedon, Nine News.
Okay, let's check in on our weather in Sydney Town. Good evening, Amber.
Good evening to you, Pete. We have enjoyed an absolutely gorgeous day in Sydney. This is DY Beach a little earlier. Certainly no sign of any rain or storms. After an overnight low of 13, the city warmed up to 25 degrees by lunchtime. Our west dipping to 10, taking a little bit longer to heat up, but also reaching 25 late this afternoon. It is going to start warming up even further tomorrow, especially in our west. I'll be back with a full forecast a little later, Pete.
Amber, thank you.